Billy Cunningham, the great American. Let's continue now. Thousands on hold. Millions are listening. And Brandon listening in Florida on WFLA. And Brandon, welcome to the Bill Cunningham Show. Brandon, how are you?
Hey, how you doing?
Good. Go ahead.
Yes. About the natural-born citizenship, I am aware that he is not eligible because the fact that he is where he was born, but because his father was not a U.S. citizen at the time of his birth.
That's another issue, but the father does not have to be. In other words, if you're born inside the country and your father is from Mexico, it doesn't make any difference. Supreme Court decisions have said if you're born inside the United States, you are a citizen, irrespective of your parental citizenship. So if a woman comes here from Guadalajara and has a kid in California, that kid is a citizen by operation of Supreme Court decision.
Yes, a citizen, but a natural-born citizen. You know, it does make him a citizen if you were born on U.S. soil, but one of the framers of the 14th Amendment actually defined a natural-born citizen as someone who is not subject to any other jurisdiction but U.S. citizen, citizenship.
Well, he is the only president ever to be born, shall I say, from an illegitimate relationship, because there's no evidence that Ann Dunham ever married Barack Hussein Obama. There's no evidence of their marriage. And there's no evidence of their divorce. And he impregnated numerous women with many children, so it's unlikely they were ever married. And if they were never married, it's unlikely they were ever divorced. And I don't blame the president for that whatsoever. And I don't blame him in that circumstance. And I don't blame him for going to Jakarta, Indonesia when he was five. And I don't blame the fact that when he was 10 years old, his mother sent him out of Jakarta back to Honolulu because she couldn't deal with him. It had nothing to do with that either. My problem is not releasing the data that
right.
would support it all. And I want to know why we allow him to be judged. And when he runs for re-election in 3 years, the campaign's going to start like in 2 years. Are we going to have any of this information now, Brandon? And the answer is no. The media won't ask. Why doesn't somebody ask him these three or four questions to see how he handles it?
You're right. I do have a problem with that. He's not releasing any of his records.
Why not?
Records. Well, he's hiding something, and, you know, that's an issue really, well, we're already discussing that. And,
you know, Brandon, every president releases medical records, not
right.
this one.
Right, and I believe he signed an executive order hiding all his records, to hide all his records.
Why?
Well, because he's apparently is not qualified to be president.
What would we do if, when he applied and went to Occidental College, he was on a Fulbright scholarship, which is only given to foreign students, and he claimed to be a student, or he claimed to be a citizen of Indonesia, to get scholarship money under the name of Barry Sartoro. Would that be like a story?
I think it will.
Why hasn't the media said to him, Mr. President, would you release your college records and release your long-form birth certificate, please, and see how he handles it? I mean, I guess he would answer the question by saying, That's already been resolved. Let's move on. But it's not been resolved. How about releasing his medical records? Some say he's lost 10 pounds. He looks gaunt and tall. He doesn't look healthy. Why doesn't he release his medical records to indicate maybe he's got some ailment? I pray to God he doesn't. But why don't we judge him by exactly the same standards that we have judged every president in the last 50 years? I don't want anything special, unique, or different. I want exactly the same standards. That's my problem. Well, let's continue with more of a line.